What?
I said this is the thing. Before I record.
Okay, it's fine. Okay, so we have done finished part 2 the last time round. So now we are going to part 3, where we look at fractional equations that can be reduced to linear equation. So what do we mean by fractional equation? Fractional equations are basically when your variables are stuck in fractions. So you can see like example, something like that. Okay, or how do we try to solve an equation like this? So it's actually not very difficult. Okay, so let me just show you. Okay, if I have, say, an equation like x minus 2, so for example, x minus 2, say,
She's
after your sister.
What?
Is he after your sister?
No, probably not.
That's what I thought also. Okay, so anyway, so for example, you have something like that. Example 1, I'll just show you an example, okay? X minus 2, okay. So how do I solve a question? Okay, 5, right? If you look at the number 5, okay, first of all, okay, if you look at minus and divide, one of the things I can do is I can try to do a multiply by 3 to both sides. Then I will carry off the 3, correct? Okay, so what I can do is you can see that from here, I can do a multiply by 3 to both sides. Okay, ma? So when I do a multiply by 3, what will happen is you can see, okay, if I do a 3 times 3, okay, you can see, what will happen to these two guys? What would happen to these two guys? Jing Kai.
X minus 6.
Okay, think about these three and these three. How will they react to each other?
The
big
one will release the other one.
They'll replace or they'll cancel?
Cancel.
Okay, so they'll cancel each other. Okay, ma? So when it's a division by 3, you replace it by a multiplication. So I have x minus 2 equals to
15.
Okay, ma? So you can see that a very simple fractional equation can become straight away linear. After that, what do I do to both sides? Now I want to make x a subject, remember? So I see a minus 2 here, right? What do I do?
Plus.
I do a plus 2 to both sides. Okay, I do a plus 2 to both sides. Alright, I add 2 to both sides. So this will give me 15 plus 2. So that gives me x equals 17. Is that okay? Okay, now very simple example. So what if I have say x minus 2? Okay, just an example, you never found it. Okay, this is the last thing I will go through. X plus 1 over 3. For example, something like that. I have two fractions. Okay, so to get to the x, what do I do? Do I need to divide the 2 first? Or do I need to multiply the 2 or add the 5? Or which one do I do first? The 2 or the 5?
I don't know. Cross multiply.
Hold on to that. Okay. So the idea is, okay, you can see that, okay, I need to carry off the 2s and the 3s, right? Right now. So here you can see if there's a divide by 3, I carry off the 3 by multiply by 3, right? Right now. Okay. Here there's a divide by 2, so I have to carry off the 2 by multiplying by 2. Here there's a 3, so I must carry off the 3 by multiplying by
2.
Okay.
Good job.
Don't be so naughty. Okay, so here there's a 2 here, right? So I will cancel this by multiplying by 2. Here, there's a 3 here, so I cancel this by multiplying by 3. Okay, no. So if I need to multiply by 2, I need to multiply by 3, what do you think I need to multiply by?
6.
How is 6 related to these 2? Yes, LCM. So you multiply by basically the LCM of the denominator. Is that okay? In this case, it is 6. Okay, ma? This is the trick, ma. So you multiply by 6, you multiply by 6. Is that okay? 6 divided by 2 will cancel with you? 3. 6 divided by 3 will cancel give you?
2.
And with that, you have 3x minus 5 equals to 2 bracket x plus 1. Sorry, just give me 2 more minutes. Okay, 3x minus 15 equals to 2x plus 2. Okay? bring the 2x over, 3x minus 2x, bring the 15 over, 2 plus 15, x, 3x minus 2x is x, 2 plus 15 is 17. Okay, wow, both 17, so nice. Is that okay? Can Okay, there's a shortcut for this. I think, who has heard of cross-multiply? Who has heard of cross-multiply? Fantastic. So let me just talk about cross-multiply. Cross-multiply says that, in general, if you have a for example, cross-multiply is a shortcut, it's a shortcut. Basically, if you have A over B equals to C over D, then this just means that A times B, if I take A multiplied by B, A multiplied by B, this is equals to B multiplied by C. Is that okay? Is that okay? This is called cross-multiply. The reason, cross-multiply is a heuristic, meaning like PSLE, some heuristics don't require you to understand. Alright, but this one is more of the understanding. Why is it cross-multiply work? Because we multiply by the LCM. Okay? So this is A times B equals to B times C. Okay? So very quickly, if I take, I'm going to do a quick test. X plus 3 over 7 equals to X minus 2 over 5. Don't see anything? Yes, come. Next line one. Of course, what do I get? Next. Equals, okay, the next person I'll ask is Ignatius. Complete question 3.1 3.1 to 3.1 and 3.2. Can? Can ah? 3.1 and 3.2.
Do I stop? Do I stop the video?
Thank you, class.